Hello and welcome to this latest video from Simple-BBQ. Today I'm going to cook a pork porchetta with you and I'm going to take you through the really simple steps to achieve this absolutely fantastic pork dish. So I didn't get the cut of meat that I really wanted, so I'm going to have to kind of make things up a little bit here. What I really wanted was the loin, which I'm just opening up, attached to the belly. So what I'm actually going to do here is use the loin that I've bought and a separate belly that I've bought, and I'm going to tie the two together and hopefully achieve something very much along the same lines as if the two pieces of meat were part of the same cut. So what I'm doing here is I'm just cutting into the meat, and what I'm trying to do is follow the natural muscle line. You can see I'm having a look at it. Just trying to follow that means that I'm not cutting into muscle, but cutting the pocket. You'll see here I can see some lines on the meat. Hopefully you can see it from the side view on, and I've sped this up a bit because it just takes a little bit more time, but you can just see there some muscle, bit of fat running between the two, so I just want to put my cut there. I did the same with the loin. I'm going to create a pocket, like I say, and then I'm going to stuff the porchetta stuffing mix in there so that the flavours really cook through the meat perfectly. So I'm just taking my time. I want to cut as much as I can, but I don't want to cut all the way through. So just checking as I go, carefully working the knife. But like I said, I don't want to separate the fat of the loin from the meat. Same with the belly. So here's my porchetta stuffing mix, and I'll put the ingredients down in the description, but just running you quickly through what I did. I just lightly toasted some pine nuts. Put those in a pan for a few moments. Just started to brown those off, release some of the flavours. I took those out, and then I put some olive oil into the pan. I softened an onion. I added loads of garlic because I absolutely love garlic. Once that had cooked down a little bit, I then added some Provençal herbs, but herbs to your taste. But I also put some celery salt, some sage in there, and once that had all finished cooking up, I then diced up some white bread and just mixed that in at the end. I didn't want to cook the white bread, I just wanted to put those in there to absorb all the flavours. With the celery salt, I didn't add any more salt. I think that would have just been too much, although of course, and you'll see in a minute, but I did put some salt on the outside to help crisp the skin up. Okay, so I'm just bringing the two pieces of meat here together, and you can see what I mean. If I'd had that piece of belly attached to the loin, it would have just rolled over and that would have given me skin around most of the joint actually. But as it is, I need to tie it anyway, so tying these two pieces together, it's not a big deal. So I'm just going to secure the first knot in the centre of my joint here. You could work from either end actually. And one of the things that I did just by tying it in the middle here really was just to kind of make sure that I had the two ends aligned where I wanted them. But you could easily just line yourself up from the end. So I'm just tying this slip knot. I'm going to put a link below to another video by Scott Ray. Brilliant video. Just tells you exactly how to tie this knot, and it works perfectly. So all you're doing is using that slip knot to tighten the pieces of meat together. You don't want to overdo it, but it will secure the two pieces of meat, and you can see as I come to secure the knot, it's not springing back on me. What I've tried to do is do this a little bit back to front to how I would normally do it, to give you a view of it. So what's that look like? Hard work. It's actually not a difficult knot to tie, and practice makes perfect. So hopefully I can just show you again another one. So I bring the string over the meat, and in my left hand I hold the two ends. In the shorter end, if you like, the piece that's passed over the top, I create a loop, pass the working end over the top of the two pieces of string, bring it back round, and then pass it back down through the loop, and that creates the slip knot. So as I pull down on that string, it just tightens nicely. to stop the string moving up and down the meat, one thing you can do is just nick the skin a little bit. I haven't done it here because it worked okay. But if you find that it's slipping and it's coming away from where you want the piece or the knot to be tied, just nick the skin a little bit, and that will give it a groove just for the string to sit inside. So I've got a few more of these knots to tie, so I've sped this up. You don't want to see it in real time. One thing I will say is with the olive oil, everything became a little bit slippery. So yeah, just take your time and all will be good. So I've spaced all my knots. You can see the tension on those is quite even. Decided to just try and get an extra one up on the ends. And also what I'm going to do now is do one loop, if you like, around the length of the meat as well, just to help try and keep those ends in. So over at my barbecue now, I've got a chimney full of briquettes going. They're just starting to grey off at the top, and I'm going to spread these evenly over either side of my barbecue that I've already got set up. I was going to try and catch all the juices, but in the end I was going to add more charcoal to this anyway, and what I proved here, by accident unfortunately, was that if you are going to tip your briquettes out of your chimney and you've got something in there that you want to keep free from those ashes, make sure you take them out. But like I say, I was going to add more charcoal to this later, so it was a bit academic for me anyway, because I had this wedged in there. If you're going to try and catch the drips for gravy or whatever, you need to find a way of putting that drip tray in the middle, but that you can access it so you can take it out later. So I put my pork onto a skewer inside, put my rotisserie stacker on top of my barbecue, and got things going. Really easy to set this up. I was after a really light smoke, didn't want too much smoke, so decided here just to put a few wood chips directly onto the charcoal. Like I say, just give me a light smoke. I didn't want intensity, just wanted a little bit of flavour on the outside. And I'm going to put the lid on to help keep that smoke inside the barbecue. So my lid's been on the barbecue for 45 minutes to an hour. I turned the lid halfway through this time. You can see things are really starting to look good, although I did use a thermometer at this point just to see how the temperature was going, and I'll just do that off screen actually. But the temperature wasn't quite where I wanted it to be, and I knew that if I had too much heat on the outside of that skin, I'm going to start seeing that burn, but without getting the meat cooked right the way through. I also knew I needed more charcoal, so I got another chimney load going about 15 minutes or so after I got the initial put the meat on and got that going. That meant I knew I had a good intense heat to finish the cook off, without kind of the panic of getting more charcoal going when things were starting to look like they may not finish cooking. So it was in the preparation, and you can see how I've taken everything apart and got my charcoal in place. So effectively, I've reset everything, back on with my stacker, got my meat ready, coming back over on the rotisserie skewer, and drop that in place. Now, like I say, I need heat to cook the meat, but I don't want too much so it starts burning. So I'm going to carry on with the rest of the cook with the lid off. That gives me heat where I want it, but not excessive, which will lead to a burn. So my 2 kilos of pork cooked like this for around about 2 hours. Once the pork was cooked, and I checked the internal temperature, and actually I was a bit over 65 and gave it a few extra minutes just because of a few other timing issues with what we were cooking to go with this. But it's time now to carve this beautiful piece of meat up. And there's no way going around this. Get your hands in there. Get that string off there. You never know, a little bit of crackling might come away, and it's going to have to be eaten. Cook's perks. So it's not a timely process, but I've sped this up to save you watching it in real time, which, well, it's got me salivating watching it back now. Hopefully it is with you as well. But I just want to get all that string off, and also something I did was found there was no way I was going to cut through the crackling with the meat. Some of it did, but I actually basically took the crackling cap off. You'll see I'll do that in a moment. Set that to one side and then break that up afterwards once the meat's all been cut up. Well, here it is actually. You can see, never going to cut that with the meat as well without just crushing the whole thing down. So I'm going to cut that lovely bit of crackling off the top there. I've got some underneath, remember, as well from the belly. I'm going to just set that off overside and I'll break that up later. But now what I've got is all my meat. The belly and the loin actually have done remarkably well to kind of stay joined up even after I've taken all the string off. And you can see nice and nice thick chunky slices. Plenty of juice in there. Meat's really nicely cooked. It's not dried out, it's beautifully moist and tender. All that delicious porchetta stuffing, it's there with my meat. And I'm going to serve this a little rustic style, you'll see in a little while. I'm just going to put it all on a plate, put it up on the table, and we're just going to get stuck in. So I'm sure you agree, this really was quite simple. Not a lot to it. Open the meat up, put my stuffing inside, put it on a rotisserie skewer, put it on a rotisserie for 2 hours, then sliced it up and served it. Nothing difficult in that, but the results are absolutely brilliant. Flavours were intense, worked all the way through the meat, delicious crackling, and very pleased with it. And I hope you'll give it a go. So thank you for watching this video from simple-bbq.com. I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen here. I hope you're inspired to have a go. Thanks for watching and please subscribe.